नमस्ते गुरुकुलियंस, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फिट एंड फाइन एट योर होम्स। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट दिस न्यू चैप्टर नंबर 6, दैट इज मैपिंग द वर्ल्ड। नाउ यू कैन सी हियर द मैप ऑल्सो, एंड यस ऑल्सो द नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर सजेस्ट दैट टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी अबाउट मैप्स इन दिस चैप्टर। वी विल स्टडी व्हाट आर मैप्स, व्हाट आर इट्स वेरियस काइंड्स, एंड व्हाट आर द सिंबल्स दैट वी यूज to represent something in a map, right? So let's start with this chapter. So yes, before studying the map, firstly you need to know about the directions. Like we already know that there are four fundamental directions, that are north, south, east and west, right? These are the four fundamental directions that we all are aware of, right? And these directions are known as cardinal directions. Okay, now this is a new word, cardinal. What does it mean? It means basic or fundamental. So we are having four fundamental directions, right? So yes, these four directions. Now you will see these directions in the map. See students, always at the top of the map there is north. This is north at the top of the map. And towards the bottom it is south. This is the south direction. And towards this, like my right side, and if I am standing here, this is my right hand. So this right side is east and this left side is west. Okay, so yes, where is north in the map? Obviously the center of attraction in this chapter is map, so we are going to relate everything with the map. So north is at the top of the map, right? And south is at the bottom. East is towards your right. And west is towards left, right? So these are the four basic directions we study. Now, in between these directions, like I have shown, this is north, this is east, west and south. Now in between these directions, like in the half of north and east, in the half of east and south, there are other directions as well. What are they called? This direction, which is halfway between north and east. So it is known as northeast. It is known as northeast, right? Now the direction which is halfway between east and south, it is known as southeast direction, right? I am writing it as SE means southeast direction. Now, in between west and south, this direction is known as southwest, right? So again, similarly, the direction between north and west, it is known as northwest direction, right? So these directions which are in between of our fundamental directions, these have a special name. These are known as intercardinal directions. So what are these intercardinal directions? These are the directions that are halfway between our fundamental or cardinal directions. These are northeast, southeast, southwest and northwest. Okay, so this is all about directions that we need to know. This is just a basic thing. Now we are coming to the major part of our chapter, that is a map, right? So yes, you studied about cardinal direction and intercardinal directions, right? So yes, now the next thing is that we are going to study is a map. So students, what is a map? This is a map. Yeah, this is a map. But the question is, how do we define map? What is the definition? If somebody asks you, how will you define a map? Then what will you say? What is a map? Map is like a drawing. You can see it is a drawing of a particular path, particular place, particular country, or even if, of a building, right? So what is a map? Map is a drawing of a place, of a building, you can say, of a country, or of world you can say, and etc. Many other things, places. This is a map of India, right? So this is a map of country, our country, India. So students, what is like I have shown here building also. Why I have written here building? Because if you notice, if there are some large construction projects, they always have, the architects always have a paper in their hand, right? So what is that paper? That paper is a drawing. Like what is their project need to be? What it will look like in a future? In future, how will it look like? So that is a map of that particular project, right? So map is a drawing. After that, what are the features of a map? Like first of all, yes, the map, it is, this map word is taken from a Latin word. It is taken from a Latin word known as mappa, right? MAPPA. The meaning of this word, what is the meaning of this word? The meaning of this word in English is sheet, cloth, or a napkin, you can see. So the map word is derived from this Latin word, right? So yes, now what is a map? Map is a drawing. What does it show? What it shows? So map shows us main features, like the place we are studying. It tells us about the place, right? Now what are its main features? Like its mountains, its rivers, physical features, okay? And it gives us all information about the place. So what is the importance of a map? Map, importance of the map is it provides us information about that place. Yes, information about the place. Now, nowadays, we all are aware of Google Maps, right? We use maps to find out a place, to get the direction of it. So you are very well aware about this, that what are the functions of a map, how we can use it, right? So yes, map tells us about the physical features, it tells us about all the information of the place, it tells us about the directions as well, right? So these are the uses of a map. After this, yes, after this, what are we going to study? We are going to study about some types of maps, okay? Before going to that topic, just have a look over this map. See, here we have, in this map we have mountains as well. These yellow, these blue are oceans, seas, mountains, all are shown in a single map. So map is a very helpful thing for us. Now moving on to types of maps. Now basically there are three types of maps, students. Okay, how many types of maps we have? We have three types of maps. Number one is physical map. Yes. Second one is political map. And the third one is a thematic map. This is derived from theme, right? Thematic map. Okay? So we will study these maps one by one. What are these and what are the differences in these maps? See students, first of all, a physical map. Physical map, as the name suggests, it tells us about the physical features of that place, of that country. What does it tell? It tells us about the physical features. Now what are the physical features? What are the physical features of a human body? These are our hands, our eyes, our ears, right? These are the physical features. Now coming on to a particular place, what are its physical features? Its physical features are its mountains, its hills, oceans, rivers, right? These are all physical plains, the plain land, right? These are all physical features of a country, of a place. So physical map is used to represent these kind of things. These kind of physical features we use to represent in a physical map, right? So coming on to second type, political map. See students, political map, we have used this map before when we located some hills like Naga Hills, Mizo Hills. I have already told you this in the Northern Mountains chapter, right? And we located some hills. What were those? like it, one was Naga Hills, it was here in Nagaland, and then we located Mizo Hills in the map, right? So that kind of maps where there is partition of states, that kind of map is known as a political map. What is a political map? The map that is having division of states, right? And if we talk about a world map, then that map that is having division of countries. So this map, if you can see, it is having a clear division, right? It is having a clear division of all the states, right? So this kind of map is a political map. Now what is the use of this map? This map is majorly, basically used to locate states and their capitals, right? We can locate in this map, like here is Rajasthan, it is Uttar Pradesh, it is Madhya Pradesh, right? So here we can use this map to locate states, their capitals as well, and yes, if there is some very like important town or city of that state, so we can locate it as well, right? So what is a political map? Political map is a kind of map having division of states in it, and we use it to locate different states, towns, cities and their capitals, right? So yes, after that, moving to the last slide, that is thematic map. Now students, what is this? I told you that it is derived from the word theme. Now if our concern is to study about a particular aspect, a particular theme, like I need to study about rivers only, I need to study about the vegetation, the crops, agriculture, then we use these kind of maps, right? So such kind of maps are known as thematic maps, because there we study only one aspect, like I am studying about rivers only, right? So that is, suppose I am studying about rivers only. This is a combined map. See, in this map, there are no states located, right? There are no physical features, but I am studying it from agriculture, from the aspect of agriculture. Then that kind of map is known as thematic map, okay? So yes, we are done with these types of map. What are three types of map? One is physical map, second is political map, and third one is thematic map. So physical map tells us about the physical features of a country, like mountains, hills, rivers, right? And then political map, it tells about us the division of states. And then thematic map, we use this when we are studying about a particular aspect only, like crop, like rivers, or only the oceans, right? So yes, now we will move to the next topic, with that is the representation. That is the representation in a map. Representation. So how I told you that we can represent states, we can represent hills, we can represent mountains in a map. Now how we do this? How do we do this? There are certain symbols, like if I want to show oceans in the map, there is a color, blue color. I'll always show oceans in the map with blue color. So like that, there are symbols for around everything. About everything we have symbols, so that for me to, like if I am drawing a map and I use that specific symbols, so for others it will be easy to understand that map. That like, see, if there is blue color, I get to know that this is an ocean, right? So this is the importance of symbols, that it makes the map for us, for others, easy to understand, right? So there are certain symbols that we use, like I told you, there is blue color map. If we are using blue color, then it is for seas, oceans, rivers and lakes, right? So blue color represents all these things. After that, if there is green color, if there is something green in the map, that represents the low-lying areas, like the plains, right? So that represents low-lying areas, green color. And yes, the planar area, and also it represents the all the deserts, right? Green color is also used to represent the deserts. And yes, the coastal area as well, that is near the coast, that area as well is represented by green color. So after that, the next is yellow. If there is a yellow color representation, then what it represents? It represents the area that are a bit higher than plains. So what does it represent? It represents the areas that are higher than plains, right? So yes, after this, there is brown color. There is dark brown color and maps that is used to represent mountains and hills. You can see such kind of representation in your book as well. There is a map drawn where these colors are shown, like with its importance and what does it represent, okay? And yes, after that, these are some colors like blue, green, yellow and brown. You must be aware about that, what are these colors representing, right? So after this, in representation, we have some certain symbols also, right? These are about large areas, very wide areas, that if I need to represent a hilly area, I'll color it brown. But what if I'm studying a small city? If I'm studying the map of a small city, there are some things like a temple, right? So it is represented as this, a dome shape and a flag on it. This symbol represents a temple, right? And yes, if I am studying in a political map about the states, so this symbol is for the state, right? This symbol is for capital of the state. And yes, if there is a square and a dot inside, it is for the capital of country, right? This is for the capital of state, this is for the capital of country. So there are many other symbols, but we will continue with that symbols, with that representation. There are many more things to know. We will continue those topics in our next class. Till then, just go through the introduction of this chapter, right? After that, we studied types of map. What is a map? Map is a drawing, right? So study these symbols, study all the representations, and we will meet in the next class. Till then, take care.